Principal Elizabeth Kelly, and I am very happy to welcome you to Lowell Elementary's Missoula Children's Theater performance of Beauty Lou and the Country Beast. Kids have worked so amazingly hard this week. This is my first experience with Missoula Children's Theater. I knew what it was, but I hadn't been at a school that had it. And I am blown away by this program and what it brings to our kids, and I can't wait for you to see them. I'm gonna do a round of special thanks to our Lowell PTA for sponsoring us this year, to our committee for all the hard work, to our staff for their flexibility and their love of this program and their everything they have done to make it possible, to all of you as families for your support with rides and making sure kids are ready to be where they need to be, to the amazing Miss Leanne Waldner, who is our piano player. And I think we're gonna do a little extra special thanks today. Thank you, Miss Leanne. Miss Leanne does it all. She supports us at recess. She supports us with behavior and social emotional support for kids, and she can play the piano. Also to Madison Community Church for their support and the flowers that your students will come home with today. To Andy and Keith for all their help. They're back in the sound booth, Auditorium Hospitality, the great tech support. We missed thanking Andy last night, so double thanks to Andy this morning. I also want to thank our, let's thank them. Also to our two MCT directors, Sammy Bonko and Ashlyn Lockhart. Ashlyn is playing the role of Buck today, and Sammy is supporting backstage as director. Just a couple more things. I want to thank Campus Security Officer Bauer and our School Resource Officer DiFolo for their support out front this morning. Couple of housekeeping rules. We ask that there be no food or drink in the auditorium, that you turn off any electronics that might make noise, and that you keep any flash photography to a minimum because it distracts the actors. There will be some directions after the play. There's a photo opportunity, and then students will need to put away their costumes. It will take us a little bit longer than last night. We ask you to stay in your seats, and we thank you for your patience. And then they will be dismissed from the stage when it's time. I think that's everything, and that's more than enough of me. So thank you, and on with the show.
Yeah. Sandy D.
Hi.
Barbie Lee.
Hi.
Bobby Joe.
Hi.
Little Zoe.
Hi.
And the apple of my eye, Beauty Lou.
Hi.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Well, now you've met my entire family. Oh, that is all except my sidekick and little buddy, that harmonious sound of Levi Clyde. Oh, mighty party, Clyde. Now get over here. You're embarrassing me.
Hey, bud. What about us?
Oh, my goodness. And these are my two farmhands, Slim and Dusty.
How?
Well, that is quite enough howdies for one day. What do you say we get back to what we came here for? Let's have some fun!
Yay!
So long, country folks!
So long, love!
Come on, Slim Dusty Pie, and come on, girls! What are you waiting for? This year's the county fair!
We're gonna look at the best display.
We always look the best! Let's look at those animals!
We're about to start the flower judging.
Already there, written for them red, red roses.
Come on, everybody, it's time for the flower judging.
face of the mountain. You know, I think I saw him sitting by himself in a cactus patch one time. He always seems to be alone. Never says a word to anybody. I'll tell you what.
What?
Judy Lou and I will deliver his blue ribbon personally.
Yeah! Whoa!
And maybe he can spare one of those roses for you, Beauty. What do you think of that?
Oh, do you really think so?
Well, we'll see now. We'll see. While we're gone, you folks enjoy yourselves here at County Fair.
Yay!
You.
is until this year. Why, the corn should be up to my shoulders by now, and it's barely knee-high to a grasshopper. I don't know how we're gonna make it.
Why, just look at this corn. You couldn't feed a field mouse with this, much less a chicken.
Well, what do you reckon we should do?
I got an idea, Buck. Why don't we go to that big rodeo?
You mean that big rodeo on the other side of those mountains?
Yep, that's the one.
I'll have to talk to my girls about that. Listen, maybe you'd better get back to your chores. What's that sound? Stampede! Oh, my goodness, it's a stampede. Run, runners, follow, slim, follow, slim.
ain't it right?
Half the day.
Time flies when you're having fun.
Oh, why, look! There's the rodeo grounds up ahead now!
Just look.
Yahoo!
Like that. anything you want. You're acting like them roses is the only beauty in your life.
I want them, and you would steal from me.
Well, yes, but I only took one, and I promise I'll pay whatever the flower's worth, but you'll have to trust my credit.
I want no money. Here, I'll even give you back this rose.
Your most prized possession for me, but what do you want in return?
In return, you shall work in my mine.
No, I can't. I mean, I have to take care of my daughters. I can't leave them all alone. Oh, please be reasonable. I beg you.
I'll stay.
No, Beauty, you stay back. I'll take care of this. Say, mister, how about I just come to work for a little while, and then I can go on home. No, you're right. I need to put in my fair share. Go on, Beauty. Go back home.
No, I can't.
But Beauty, if you stay, you'll have to live in that dark and cold cave with the bats and the rats and...
Beauty shall never be harmed. She will be our honored guest. And she'll have all the gold she desires.
Well, I don't care how much gold you give her. You just can't do that.
Oh, Mama, when Pa passed on, you had to take care of me and my sisters all on our own. And now it's time for me to take care of you.
All right. Now, mister, if you harm so much as one hair on her little head.
I could not. I would not, for she is as special as a rose.
You promise?
I promise. Now off with you. As for Beauty, supper time.
All right. Well, I'm leaving. I won't disrupt your supper. Whew, don't worry, Beauty. Everything's gonna be just fine. That country beast of a fella gave me his promise, and like I always told you,
a promise is a promise.
So I got going. With my head hung low and my spirits even lower, I started walking back to the barn. But just before I lost sight of the cave, I turned back for one last look at Beauty. And when I did, I saw the strangest thing. Beauty Lou was talking to someone. Except the funny thing was, there was nobody there to listen to her. At least nobody that I could hear. Now, I couldn't hear exactly what she was saying, but it looked like she was explaining what had happened.
If I didn't, then we would all lose the farm. I understand you, Beauty. It is the right thing. And don't worry, you won't be alone. I'll be there with you. No. I mean, you can't. The beast will be upset if someone else is here with me, even if you are invisible. Hold on. But if I leave, who will be your friend?
The beast will be my friend.
The beast? Nobody wants to be his friend.
Well, maybe it's time they did.
I understand. Just know you will see me when the time is right. When next to wish upon a wishbone, I'll be there. Goodbye for now, Beauty Lou. Bye for everyone.
And just like that, Beauty Lou was gone. Oh, I felt awful and ashamed, but I knew that Beauty was right. I had to get back to the farm and my daughters, or else her sacrifice would have been for nothing. At least I wouldn't be going home alone. Fleabag, Clyde, it's all right. You can come out now. Oh, yeah. Some guard dog you turned out to be. Oh, where's Beauty? She's gonna have to stay in the mine for a while. Forever. Oh, yeah. Poor Clyde. I couldn't help but feel sorry for him. Beauty Lou was always his favorite. Now, when I got back to the farm, I sat myself down in the moonlight, and I thought, and I thought, and I thought. I thought about how brave Beauty Lou was and how she would always do anything to help her family. Now, I don't think you'll hurt her, but still, did I make the right choice? When the sun came up, I heard the rooster crow. I knew I had to find my daughters to tell them what Beauty Lou had done for them, but I reckon they're still asleep. Oh, I can't listen to that. Nothing like the sound of my critters to get my mind off my troubles. Now, what you're about to hear, folks, is real country music. So, just listen up for a second. Now, when you think of country music, you probably think this way.
We do!
About a cowboy's love. in bass section. On the keyboard, a group that never lays an egg and always wakes you up. On percussion, a group of drum and donkeys raring to go. On the strings, the perkiest vessel of ponies in the country.
Yeah.
honored and ungrateful.
Why would you say that about yourself?
There was a time I had many friends, but my pride in my lips and my room began to change as a person.
That's terrible.
Go home, Gordian. Visit your mom, sisters. Tell them that you and I are
friends.
Friends! We're friends, aren't we?
Oh, yes, we are indeed.
Well, supper time.
Okay.
Meanwhile, back on the farm, things were going pretty well thanks to the gold that Beauty Lou had sent along. Oh, still. Dusty and I would set ourselves down in the moonlight, and we would sing those sad cowboy songs that we used to sing when the girls were small. Oh, hey, do y'all remember this song? You know, it's one of the saddest, but boy, oh boy, it is one of my favorites.
A cowboy's life is miserable.
about our predicament since you've been gone, and I realize there's a part of this story that you forgot. You see, I remember a county fair years ago. I remember a handsome young fellow who grew roses outside of his mind, but he was mean and spiteful and let nobody near his roses. I also remember a young girl named Beauty Lou who was so mad at that fellow she could spit, and she wished. Yeah, she wished upon a wishbone that that fellow would look like a beast. And you know what I always told you about wishbone wishes?
That they always come true.
Yes. Well, say, I've got an idea. You're pretty good at this wishbone wishing, and maybe, just maybe, since you're the one who wished he looked like a beast, well, maybe you can wish him back again. Back to the handsome young fellow he was before.
Oh, yes, let's hurry.
Yes, and hurry we did. We ran and we ran and we ran past the picket fence and beyond the mountains. We ran until it was nearly sundown and started to get dark. Oh, not that dark. Oh, thank you. Oh, my goodness, there he is, Beauty. Hurry and get some wishbone wishing.
I wish I wish upon a wishbone that you shall be a beast no more. I wish that you will be as handsome as you are in your heart.
I'm sorry, Beauty. I don't think it worked.
Oh, I don't care what you look like. I just want you to come back and be my friend forever.
Wait a minute, Beauty. What's that out here?
Part of me, the Frank Hart.
on Monday and learn this whole show in just 5 days. Let's give another round of applause.
Hello. Ooh, this is fun. Thank you so much to Miss Leanne for being our wonderful accompanist. Thank you to Miss Dowdy for being our contact this week. Miss Lisa, Miss Stacy, all the parents and volunteers who were helping backstage. Thank you guys so much. We could not have done this without you. Takes a lot of people to get this show on the road. So thank you to everybody who was helping this week. Thank you so, so much. And thank you to our national sponsor, Cosmic Crisp, a new kind of apple. All righty. Very soon, we will be doing a photo call where you guys can take pictures. We're going to do a group picture first with everybody, and then we're going to do the smaller groups. And they know that after their group has been dismissed, they are to take off their costume in the dressing rooms and take their bag with them and turn in their costume to Miss Sammy. So if they come at you still in their costumes, please send them back because we need all the costume pieces for next week. I will be down here selling Beauty Lou and the Country Beast t-shirts modeled by the beautiful Sammy Bonko here. They are $16. We take card, preferably, or if you have exact change, like exactly $16, we could do that as well. We just don't have change for more cash transactions. Also, if you would like a free, that's right, I said free, workshop on how all of this fits in the back of our Chevy Colorado, we would love to show you how. But if you have places to be, we totally understand. Alrighty, so without further ado, country folks, stand on up. Slim and Dusty and Clyde, stand on up. And everybody else, stay where you are and face the cameras for a big, big smile.